face livery scheme. From Alliance, we've followed the North Platte River west along the Burlington Northern line as far as Douglas, pausing to film at Guernsey facility of the Burlington Northern. And then we've headed 30 miles north to this spot, which gives new definition to the middle of nowhere, Bill, Wyoming. And as usual, when we arrive, the tracks are under repair. We've passed four northbound trains waiting to pass this spot. Situated here are car repair facilities. We're expected to see plenty of coal hoppers today. They're not arriving upside down and off their trucks. Modern aluminium cars, badly damaged. The road vehicles delivering the damaged hoppers are having the greatest difficulty. One would have imagined decent road access would be essential to a heavy repair plant like this. A narrow dirt road is all there is. First of the three seems to have made it round the sharp end. No, maybe not. Of the three, this one seems to be the worst damaged. Well, after 20 minutes of struggling, it's still there with the first of the hopper cars. And if these guys can't get it through, nobody can. Looks like he may have succeeded this time. Yes, he has. Well, the following two drivers now know it's possible. Past one, and this is the only activity on the railway line. Waited over an hour for a train. We know there are at least four stacked up waiting. He must have heard me. Well, track machines are fine, but we came here to film coal trains. After 2.5 hours waiting for the track gangs to clear, our first coal train hove into sight over the horizon. It's 2:20 in the afternoon. At 14:33, the next in the parade. Another Burlington Northern train. Popping or thudding sound that can be heard isn't the train misfiring, it's the diesel gas engines for these oil pumps that are scattered around here. these are aluminium hoppers as opposed to aluminium gondolas. Same two trains are seen again, 3 miles nearer to Bill, Wyoming. At the moment there are trains all over the place. It's a train jam. Maybe this Chicago Northwest and Southbound will take the cork out of the bottle. At 3:15 now. I can see four Burlington Northern trains, all empties, northbound, all stationary and have been for some time. The Chicago and Northwestern train is leaving the Chicago Northwestern yard with Union Pacific power on the point, and another Chicago and Northwestern train has stopped further back on the main line. Popping sound of oil pumps is everywhere up here. 12,000 square miles of Wyoming have coal just below the surface, in seams as thick as 125 feet. Nice low sulfur coal. 40% of the coal reserves of the United States lie below this plain. Trains weigh up to 18,000 tons, so it's not surprising they take a bit of getting into motion. 2:04 with the last rays of the sun. The next Chicago Northwestern climbs the hill towards us, having been stopped at signals. And in the background, one of the Burlington Northern trains, one of the empties, has got going after a long delay. Burlington Northern train was sitting a couple of miles down the track at 11:30 when I arrived. It's now 4:00. 23 minutes past four. Another of the blocked up trains gets on the move, and behind it, headlights of two further trains, standing nose to tail, quite literally. Ahead are obstinately on red. The dispatcher has allowed the following train through the red light. Behind this one. The next train is a Chicago and Northwestern. The sun has gone down and the temperature is dropping remarkably quickly. Wednesday, the 18th of November, 8:19 in the morning, and the situation seems to pick up where we left yesterday, with a traffic jam of these huge coal trains waiting to approach Bill. This location is Lightning Creek, 8:29. The northbound train is still waiting. This is Palmer Lake on the Santa Fe and Denver and Rio Grande joint line between Denver and Pueblo. Powder River Coal Basin train heads south towards Palmer Lake, where the helpers will be cut off. Helpers have been cut off just round the bend. The helpers will now return to Denver.